Welcome back, students. I hope that yesterday's class on note making was useful to you. And today, because this is the second day, and I think I should start with a simpler lesson. And I thought that a photograph poem written by Shelty Tolson is going to be a better option. Dear children, this is the first poem in your hornbill, and you can see the photograph of Shelley Tolson here. Let us learn something about Shelley Tolson. The main thing which we should learn about Shelley Tolson is that she was born in Thames, England in 1924, and she was passionate about creative writing and was greatly influenced by her father, who was a writer as well. And in 1987, her major work, Celtic Alternatives, made her famous as a reputed writer. Okay, so let's come back. One thing more, the names of the writers is very difficult to pronounce, so let us see the correct pronunciation.
Shirley Tulson.
I hope it's clear.
Shirley Tulson.
Once more?
Shirley Tulson.
Okay. So now, we will go back to our page. So what are going to be your learning outcomes today? So the learning outcomes after this class, what you are going to learn, that is, you will be able to paraphrase a spot for the poem Photograph written by Shirley Tulson. You will be able to identify the figure of speech used in the poem. You justify the title of the poem, and you will able to analyze the important phrase in the poem. So the learning experiences which you are going to have is acquisition, discussion, and practice, because it's a poem. So now, without taking much time, let's come directly to the poem, A Photograph. So first of all, I will read the poem and then we will have the discussion, the explanation. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. Each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's. That was before I was born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. "See Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach." The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. Both free with a labored ease of loss. Now, she has been dead nearly as many years as the girl lived. And of this circumstance, there was nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. So this was the poem. Now let us discuss the poem, the explanation of the poem, line by line. So, the very first, the cardboard. The poem is a photograph, but here it says the cardboard. What does cardboard mean? Cardboard actually is you must have seen some of the photo framed photographs. Generally in the old times, what happened that people used to paste their photograph on a cardboard and they used to frame it. Now we have vinyl sheets and the different types of photo frames. So the cardboard here means the photograph. So the photograph shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. Who is me here? The poetess. How it was when the two girls went paddling? Two girls, cousin. So she is talking about two girl cousin of someone. When they went paddling. This paddling word is, it has many meanings. Because this happened, you will come to know here near the sea. We have read it, sea. So it was a holiday at the sea beach. So paddling means many things. Number one, it means rowing a boat using the paddles. Number two, it is walking or standing barefooted in the shallow water. And went paddling also means that swimming with short movements of hands or feet up and down. So here any meaning will be okay, because it all means that all these things happen when we go for a holiday on a sea beach. Anyway, each one holding one of my mother's hands. So what these two girls' cousins were doing? They were holding the hands of poetess mother. And she, the big girl, some 20 years or so. Why they were holding the hand? Because this mother, the mother was actually the oldest of all these three girls. So she was holding the hands of these two, her two cousins, and she was in the middle. Here, first of all, I would like to say two things you have to see. First of all, what is here described is actually the photograph. What the photograph is. So photograph is showing three girls. Out of the three girls, one was mother of the poetess, and she was holding the hands of her girl cousins, who were actually younger to her. She was the oldest of all. Next, so this was the scene. The three girls were standing beside the beach, and these three girls, out of these three girls, the mother was standing in the middle, and she was holding the hands of her two younger girl cousins. When did it happen? When was this photograph clicked? When she was 12 years or about 12 years old. So again, what was picturized? All three stood still to smile. So they were smiling for the photograph click. So we're smiling, these three girls were smiling for the photograph. How? Through their hair. Maybe it was very windy, so the hairs must be there on their face, and out of those hairs they were smiling. The smile could be seen. And yes, who was clicking that photograph? The uncle. The uncle was clicking the photograph with his camera. So from here to here we find the description of the photograph. So what was actually visible in the photograph? So three girls, the mother of the poet, she was holding the hands of her two little girl cousin who were younger to her. They were posing for the photograph. Uncle of poetess mother was clicking the photograph. They all were smiling for the photograph, and their smile was visible through their hair, because their hat was the face was covered with the hair. Now she says, a sweet face, my mother's. The poetess say that her mother was beautiful, she has a sweet face. And when? Before I was born. Before she was not born, she was young lady. And the sea which appears to have changed less. And the sea which appears to have changed less was their terribly transient fate. The sea and feet, these two are compared here. So one more thing, which first of all let us see the photograph. So in the photograph there were these three girls, they were smiling. Mother was in the middle holding the hands of her cousins, and they were smiling through there for the photograph near the sea beach. But one thing more we will see. Why? Because they were standing near the beach where the sea water was washing their feet. Okay, so this was the photograph. But here the poet, she compares here sea and feet. You have to understand. In the photograph, the sea which is seen is even now appear to have changed less. Of mother, they were terribly transient. Here are two figure of speeches, though we are going to discuss all the figure of speeches later on. But here is transient epithet. This adjective terrible is given to transient feet. To understand now, what does this phrase means? Terribly transient feet. What does terribly mean? Terribly means extremely. Transient, temporary, and feet, yellow, symbolic of humans. So here it is shown that the natural things are comparatively permanent, whereas the human beings, they are not permanent. Or you can say that the natural objects like sea, they are immortal, they never die, whereas the human beings, they die. Yes, and even the little change which could be visible in these natural objects, it is just because of the interference of human beings. Nature is same as it is. So the last two lines of the first stanza are very important. It shows the permanence of nature and the temporary nature of human lives. I hope the first stanza is quite clear. Now let us come to the second stanza. Okay, fine, let me read the first stanza again. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. Each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through the hair at the uncle with the camera. The sweet face my mother's that was before I was born, and the sea that which appears to have changed less, wash their terribly transient feet. I hope this stanza is clear. If you have any difficulty, you may drop the message in the comment box. Now, second stanza. Some 20-30 years later, means after this episode, when they have gone for sea beach holiday. So after either 20 years or 30 years, what would happen? She would laugh at this snapshot. Who is she here? She here is mother of the poet. What was her reaction on seeing the photograph? She used to laugh at the snapshot. Why? Because she was amused to see that. And she used to comment, what? See Betty and Dolly, and look how they dressed us for the beach. So she used to laugh at the weird dressing style of them in the photograph. So it appears to be weird to her. So she would say that, see Betty and Dolly, and look how they dressed up for the beach. And she would laugh, and her laugh would echo the room, because it was full of happiness when she used to look at the photograph. Okay, fine, move to the next lines. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. Why? Because sea holiday happened when she was 12 year old. Who? The mother of poet was 12 year old. And why? And what was past for the poet? That her mother is no more. Now she could not listen to the laughter of her mother. So here she talks about two loss. Number one, the loss of mother. She is no more. This is loss for the poet. She could not listen to her laughter. Second loss is the loss of mother, that she couldn't experience that happiness again which she had at the sea beach holiday. What? So there are two loss. One is the loss of poet, the other is the loss of poet's mother. This is very important line. You have to understand it. Both read with the labored ease of loss. To explain this line, I would like to comment on this word rye. It is not re, it is rye. This rye word is actually, it means ride also in English, according to Merriam-Webster dictionary, and which means twist or intervene. So twist or intervene, you can say mixed feelings. So these two episodes, number one, that the holiday at sea beach for the mother, and the laughter of mother seeing the photograph that was simply loved by her daughter, the poet. These two episodes have mixed feelings, intervened. How? With labored ease of loss. Labor, you understand. Now understand first of all what is labor. Labor means when you work hard. What to work hard? To ease the loss. What is it? See, take one by one. Let us take the example of poet's mother. The poet's mother best time was when she had a holiday at the sea beach when she was 12 years old. After that she didn't go to that such kind of holidays where she can live her life free without any tension. Okay? And this happiness is now also mixed with a tinge of sorrow. How? Because now she is sorry that she could not experience the same feelings again. So one is happiness and the second is feeling of loss. Okay? And what she did? Because time, you know, is the best healing. Time has the best healing power. With due time, they work hard to ease their loss and take it easily. Okay? Second, both here refers to both mother and the poet. Poet and poet's mother. So now we are clear with the first example. Both, the number one is the poet's mother. So she has the experience she had, have both the feelings, positive and negative, both happiness and sorrow, both. Now let us come to the poet. What was the happy hours for poet? The happy hours for poet was to listen to the laughter of her mother. Okay? But now she is unhappy. Why? Because her mother is no more. She is dead. So again both feelings, happiness and sorrow. And again the time has cured this sorrow and they have worked hard to ease this loss. I hope this explanation is clear. Once again I am going to read it. Some 20-30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot. "See Betty and Dolly," she would say. "And look how they dressed us for the beach." The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. Both rye both vie with the labored ease of loss. Okay, now come to the last lines. Now she had been dead nearly as many years as the girl lived. What does it mean? Poet's mother is dead now, but how long? As the girl lived. So what was the age of girl? Her mother is a girl, 12 years. So it clearly shows that now her mother is dead for almost 12 years. Okay. Now she had been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. Which girl? The mother as girl lived in the photograph. What was her age? 12 years. Okay. And now of this circumstance. So what is the circumstance? The circumstance is that Poe's mother is dead now. Okay? She is dead now. She is no more. And she is having the painful memory of her mother's death. She is having the painful memory of her mother's death. And now, because the circumstance is so much challenging, so much demanding, there is nothing to say at all. She couldn't say anything. Sometimes it happens when your feelings are overloaded. You're overloaded with your feelings. You don't say much. Then what happens? It's silence silences. What silence? The silence of death has silenced everything. What silenced? Silence the laughter of mother, silence of the experience of daughter listening to her mother's laughter. So the silence of death has silenced everything. I would like to read these lines again. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived, and of this circumstance there is nothing to say at all. It's silence silences. Dear children, I would like to read this poem once again. A photograph by Shelley Thorson. And I hope, and I want you to pay attention to my words and also try to feel that yes, you are understanding the lines, because already the explanation has been done. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through the air at the uncles with the camera. A sweet girl face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Some 20, 30 years later, she would laugh at the snapshot, see Betty and Dolly. And she would say, "And look how they dressed us for the beach." The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter, both vie with the labored ease of loss. And she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. The silence silences. So, okay. This poem explanation is over. Now let us come to the next point. Yes, the important points other than the explanation you have to remember. Number one, this poem is an embodiment of time and timelessness. What is that? It shows the same, the last line of this first stanza, that the sea appears to have changeless and watch their terribly transient face. It shows the permanence of nature and mortal nature of human life. This poem is melancholic, means sad. Yes, obviously, they all throughout all these stanzas you find a note of sadness is there. Next, this poem is nostalgic. What does it mean? Nostalgic is a feeling of pleasure and also slight sadness when you think about things that happened in the past. Yes, so here you see. Both Y with the labored ease of loss, it clearly reflects that the poet is nostalgic. And yes, there are three different phases of life explained in this poem. Number one, a 12-year-old girl with a pretty smiling face. So, childhood. In the first stanza. Second, have a happy, youthful laughter before the poet was born. She used to laugh. She used to be very happy. Okay. And when she was happy, she was happy to look at the photograph, and also when the poetess was not born. And the third stage, one is childhood, young age, and the last is death. She died. How? 12 years back, when this poem was written. So after these important points, because one of your important, I would say that your learning outcome was to try to understand the figure of speech. So let us do it. You may see this photograph, though I have put it in the additional, somewhat like that. Terribly transient feet, holding the hands, she the eldest. Okay. So here is a quiz. I will share the link in the comment box. The cardboard. So which figure of speech is used here? Dear children, you can use this quiz for revision as well. Before exam, I will be sharing this link in the comment box with you. The figure of speech used here is allusion. Why? Because the cardboard leg, hints durability. The cardboard, sorry, this apostrophe S I am going to remove. This is wrong. The cardboard leg durability, which hints that the leg permanence of human life. Again, what is allusion? Allusion is a brief and indirect reference. So, when the poet refers to cardboard, cardboard doesn't know, it means only the photograph, but it also reflects on the same idea which has been there in the last two lines of the first stanza. It shows the temporary nature. Cardboard is, you know, very fragile. It doesn't last long. Similarly, the human beings also, the life doesn't end long, goes long. It ends whenever the time comes. Okay. So now let us come to the next. Stood still to smile. I feel like it is easy for you to make out. Yes, alliteration, because the sound and letter, both the things, sound letter S is repeated. Now let us move to the next. Terribly transient feet. This has two figure of speech. We will see one. The first is alliteration. Yes. Terribly transient. T sound is repeated, not S. T sound is repeated. And next, terribly transient. Transfer epithet also, because terrible is an adjective. And in transfer epithet is an epithet, or you can say an adjective, grammatically qualifies a noun. So feet is a noun and terrible is qualifying feet. So here it is transferred epithet. Next, labored is very important. Labored is actually oxymoron. What is oxymoron? Oxymoron is when two opposite ideas describe the same entity. So here labored means difficulty, ease, you know, easy. So two opposite ideas like difficulty and easy, both are put together to explain one entity. So here it is oxymoron. Come to the next. Silence is very important. Silences, yes, alliteration, SS, because sound S is repeated. Come to the next. Silence says there is one more. Figure of speech, that is personification. Why? Because personification is applied when a non-human object are portrayed in such a way that we feel they have the ability to act like human beings. So here silence is an abstract idea, but here it is acting as noun, and it is silencing, doing some action of silencing which human beings do. So it is personification also. Next, my mother. Easy. Alliteration. M sound repeated. And last, through the air. Again, alliteration. T sound is repeated. So I'm going to share, I will share this link in the dialogues box with you. Okay, so I have shared the link. Yes, one thing more is reference to the context. Dear children, I have made this for my students, but no problem, you can also access it. So again, I am going to give you the link to this Google form where you can practice your reference to context. Okay, the lines and then the questions you can practice. So I will be uploading mind map too very soon, and I hope that you have understood this poem very nicely, class 11, and you must practice. And if you want to go through some extra, links are also there, and very soon mind map will also be uploaded here. Okay, so that's the end of today's lesson. Thank you for your patience. See you soon. Bye.